We live in a world of data. Lots of data. Like, seriously, it's a huge amount of data. And the truth is, as the amount of data has grown larger and larger over time, it's become essentially impossible for humans like you and me to understand and process. This is even more true of geospatial data, which adds the extra complication of being mapped onto the vastness of the real world. For example, take a look at this array of coordinates. What do you think that this data represents? Go ahead, I'll give you a second to look it over. Did you guess it? The location of cities, maybe? The flight path of a particularly interesting bird or something like that? Well, no matter what you guessed, you're totally wrong. Ready for the answer? It's absolutely nothing. I actually generated this data by smashing my hands on the keyboard over and over until I got a whole bunch of numbers that looked like they made a fancy looking array. And the point is this: we literally can't look at this or even any real data and understand what it represents, let alone gain any insights from it. So what can we do? How do we make sense of data in the real world? Well, we can use the Maps JavaScript API to visualize that data on the map, giving us the ability to view it within the context of the real world. So how are we going to do that? We can use markers, right? The answer to that is a firm and resounding maybe. Because if you've used the Maps JavaScript API to put more than a few hundred markers on the map before, you know that at that scale, performance issues may start to occur. This is where deck.gl comes in. So deck.gl is an open source data visualization framework that's WebGL accelerated, meaning it uses WebGL to give us extra rendering power and performance by utilizing the GPU on the client. Also, deck.gl is built specifically, though not exclusively, for a geo or mapping use case. It also gives us a bunch of beautiful visualizations right out of the box while providing support for handling massive datasets. And the good news is, you can use deck.gl with the Google Maps JS API right now. So how does it work? So deck.gl takes a layer-based approach to data visualization. This means we can create one or more instances of the framework's available data visualizations and render them as a stack, which is useful for aggregating multiple or extremely large datasets into a single visualization. The first thing we need to do is get these layers on the map. But it's not enough to just place them on top of the map. We need to ensure that they stay in sync with the map as the user does things, for example, like panning and zooming. To handle this, deck.gl takes advantage of a feature of the Maps JS API called Overlay View. Overlay View creates a transparent layer that sits on top of the base map and syncs with its movements. Developers have actually been using Overlay View for a long time as a way of drawing over the map. And deck.gl takes this a step farther by offering a special class called Google Maps Overlay, which creates an instance of Overlay View and injects its WebGL rendering context into it. The result is that you can use many of deck.gl's beautiful data visualizations with the Maps.js API, and they stay perfectly in sync with the base map. So if you're ready to give it a try, in my next Geocast, I'll walk you through some demos of how you can use deck.gl to optimize data visualization in Google Maps. Thanks for watching, see you next time, and happy mapping. Ha! You're wrong. No matter what you guessed, you're totally wrong.
Let's do that one more time.
Sure. This is a much more like easy and natural joke when I do it in person. okay, here we go.